NBC reporter asks what are Trump's flaws, Sanders points it back at him. Nice. Does this lady think on her feet or what? White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders is one sharp lady. Of course, we all know by now if it weren't for the MSM, the Democrats and the rhinos, Trump would be moving forward a lot faster with his agenda to make America great again. But what a surprise, right? The MSM and the liberal press have done nothing to support President Trump, so why start now? When they step out of line at any press conference, you can bet WH Press Secretary Sanders lets them know about it. For example, during a press briefing following the October 31st terrorist attack in New York City, NBC's Peter Alexander asked Sanders to list the president's flaws. Yesterday from that podium, you said all of our leaders have flaws. Washington, Jefferson, Roosevelt, and Kennedy. What are President Trump's flaws? Alexander asked. The press secretary Sanders didn't miss a beat in her perfect response. Probably that he has to deal with you guys on a daily basis, she answered, not being fooled by the reporter's attempt to get her to talk negatively about Trump. Alexander, of course, didn't want to accept the answer, and tried to argue that the president doesn't actually deal with the media on a daily basis. Most every day, actually, Sanders responded. When the reporter asked, again, for the press secretary to identify an actual flaw, Sanders stood firm. I just gave you one, Sanders said, moving on to another reporter. Watch the exchange here. The day before, Sanders had argued that all of our leaders have flaws, Washington, Jefferson, JFK Roosevelt in an attempt to defend White House Chief of Staff John Kelly, who controversially said that the Civil War was the result of two parties refusing to compromise, according to AOL News. Sanders is right. Everyone has flaws, even those we select as our leaders, including President Trump. But, that doesn't mean that those entrusted with serving the interests of the president's administration should get up and list all the ways in which he isn't perfect. After all, what would that accomplish besides giving the liberal media another opportunity to denounce this presidency? You would think these reporters would have something better to ask, perhaps, say, about the recent terrorist attack or tax reform or any of the other countless real issues facing our country, than trying to engage in an argument with Press Secretary Sanders. Deputy White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders was promoted to the position of White House Press Secretary back in July. The move came just hours after former Press Secretary Sean Spicer announced his resignation. Unlike many of the president's top aides, Sanders was bred in politics. She's the daughter of former Arkansas governor and two-time presidential candidate Mike Huckabee. She served as field director for her father's 2002 gubernatorial re-election campaign, was the national political director for his 2008 presidential campaign, and headed his 2016 presidential bid. Following Huckabee's withdrawal from the Republican primary race in February 2016, Sanders signed on as a senior advisor to the Trump campaign, later becoming a frequent spokesperson. Since January, she served as the principal deputy press secretary at the White House before taking over duties as the White House press secretary. She served as a senior advisor to Tim Pawlenty in his 2012 presidential run. She was also involved in the campaigns of John Boozman, Republican Arkansas, 2010 campaign and serving as an advisor to Tom Cotton's, Republican Arkansas, 2014 campaign. Huckabee Sanders is Mike Huckabee's daughter and is married to Brian Sanders, Huckabee's 2016 media consultant. Early career. Huckabee Sanders initially worked in politics as a field coordinator for Mike Huckabee, R., in his 2002 Arkansas gubernatorial re-election, as a regional liaison for congressional affairs at the U.S. Department of Education, and as an Ohio field director for George W. Bush's, R., 2004 presidential campaign. In 2008, Huckabee Sanders worked as the national political director for Huckabee's presidential campaign, and, according to the campaign, directed the Iowa campaign to a landslide upset victory in the Iowa caucuses. A 2007 profile in Time magazine noted that Huckabee Sanders' time in the 2008 campaign was spent working up to 90 hours a week, running her father's schedule and event briefings not only in Iowa but in South Carolina and New Hampshire. In addition, she oversaw outreach and acted as her dad's surrogate in Iowa. USA Today noted that she advised her father on everything from debate strategy to tie selection. Father and daughter became close, personally and politically, during regular Wednesday breakfasts while he was governor of Arkansas. After Huckabee withdrew from the race, she became the director of HUGPAC, a political action committee founded to promote conservative principles and help elect conservative candidates at every level of government. Arkansas politics. As campaign manager for John Boozman's Republican Arkansas 2010 U.S. Senate race, Huckabee Sanders worked to position Boozman's opponent as a solid vote for President Obama and Boozman as an alternative who stands up to the Obama administration's reckless agenda, according to the campaign's website. During the campaign, Huckabee Sanders stood in for Boozman, who was then in the House of Representatives, in the first debate of the Republican primary. Huckabee Sanders insisted that Boozman was unavailable to debate himself because he was in D.C. fighting against the Senate health care bill. That year, she also married fellow campaign consultant Brian Sanders, who she met during Mike Huckabee's 2008 presidential campaign in Iowa. Huckabee Sanders was also named to Time magazine's 40 Under 40 in 2010. She told the magazine that the most important issue to her was family. America needs more fathers taking an active role in their children's lives. Kids who are the victims of broken families are more likely to end up in poverty, rehab, or jail. I'm a Republican, but I respect President Obama for setting the right example and addressing this problem. I hope more people will join him in his efforts. During the 2012 Republican presidential primary, Huckabee Sanders joined the campaign for Tim Pawlenty, focusing initially on Pawlenty's Iowa campaign. Of her decision to join Pawlenty's campaign, she said, "I'm delighted to join the governor and first lady in Iowa, which holds a special place in my heart. It's clear to me that Gov. Pawlenty has what it takes to unite the party, unite the country and beat President Obama." At the time of her hiring, in July 2011, Pawlenty was trailing in the Iowa polls. The Los Angeles Times noted that Huckabee Sanders fits with Pawlenty's current all-Iowa, all-the-time strategy at that point in his campaign. In addition to her work on elections, Huckabee Sanders began as a full-time consultant at Samatil's Strategies in 2011 and became vice president of their group in January 2014. While there, Huckabee Sanders worked with the One Campaign, founded by U2's Bono, as well as several Fortune 500 companies, according to the company's website. Huckabee Sanders left Samatil's Strategies in June 2015 and founded her own consulting firm, Second Street Strategies, in February 2016. In May 2016, Huckabee Sanders signed on as a senior advisor to Missouri gubernatorial candidate John Bruner, R. At the time of her hiring, the Missouri Times reported that Huckabee Sanders would serve as a senior advisor to the campaign, and will be guiding and executing the campaign's strategy on faith voter outreach. From there, well, it's history. Sanders and her dad are close. She told Time that her father was her political hero. "He's an amazing politician, but an even better parent," she said. "Every day he challenges me to be a better person and I will forever be grateful for that." She has two older brothers, but according to her brother David, she is the chosen one. "She is the only girl, and the youngest, and unquestionably spoiled," her father told Yahoo. And the father and daughter speak most mornings before 6, according to the Associated Press. "I'll call and say, 'What do you think if I say this?' He'll say, 'That's really good. You might try to say it a little bit more like X,'" she told the AP. Her father also says he's heard praise from the president. "Every time I talk to him, he'll say, 'Huckabee, I like you. You're a great guy. You're terrific, but your daughter, she's so much better.'" "She's so much better," Huckabee said. In an interview with Stephanopoulos, Sanders used a peculiar analogy to describe how she views Trump's relationship with the media. Frankly, George, I think if the president walked across the Potomac, the media would report that he can't swim, she said. Like I said, White House Press Secretary Sarah Huckabee Sanders is one sharp lady. She's doing a tremendous job of defending the president and his policies to make America great again. Keep up the nice job, Sarah.